concern for many citizens and many enterprises.
The second point, we are convinced that a no-deal withdrawal
would cause enormous damage to citizens and enterprises, and it should be avoided
in ogni modo, anche se non ad ogni
every
costo.
Way.
Questa uscita senza accordo.
Even though not at every
cost. Punto, il Parlamento auspica che in tempi rapidi si possa giungere ad un accordo tra maggioranza e opposizione a Westminster,
un accordo che vada nella giusta direzione. The majority and the opposition in Westminster as soon as possible, an agreement that goes in the right direction. Fourth point, we think future relations with the UK should still be close relations, strong relations.
So we want greater clarity in the declaration on future relations,
which could foresee the participation of the UK in the customs union or in the internal market. Fifth point, any agreement between the majority and the opposition in the UK must be compatible with our fundamental principles of integrity of the internal market, the indivisibility of the four fundamental freedoms. This is a key point which the Parliament is not prepared to give ground on. And our decision-making autonomy. Sixth point, we would like Mrs. May to clarify the framework within which negotiations between Conservatives and Labour are taking part. We'd like to know what exactly is being negotiated on in London and whether in the immediate future there will be a clear majority in favour of an agreement, and if not, what way does the British government intend to follow to get out of this situation? A referendum, general election, decidere poi magari ripresentarlo.
Noi riteniamo che soltanto con queste condizioni che abbiamo posto il Consiglio europeo possa accordare un periodo di estensione.
È ovvio, è il settimo punto,
che per noi un'estensione non può avere lo scopo di riaprire l'accordo di uscita se non per eventuali accordi puramente tecnici,
e se non può nemmeno essere l'occasione per negoziare l'accordo sulle relazioni future, either for renegotiating the agreement on future relations, because that can only be done once the UK has become a third country. So first of all, they have to leave before they can start negotiating about future relations. The eighth point,
riveste straordinaria importanza,
which is of extraordinary importance to us because it's about the dignity
e l'autorevolezza delle istituzioni europee.
Authoritativeness of European
ogni
institutions.
Estensione concessa che vada al di là della data delle elezioni europee.
Any extension which goes beyond the date of the European elections should involve an obligation on the UK to take part in those
elections.
Noi però
non possiamo accettare che le elezioni
europee
siano considerate una sorta di gioco,
the European elections being dealt with as a sort of game,
751 per un anno.
Parliament having 751 members 1 year, 705 the next year, and then some MEPs leaving, others arriving. Because the European Parliament is the home of democracy, we cannot jeopardize the principle of popular representation because of this uncertainty.
Studiare una formula di passaggio,
we can study a transition formula,
vivere nell'incertezza.
But
noi
we cannot live in uncertainty.
Cosa accadrà e quanto durerà il periodo eventuale di transizione.
We must know what is going to happen and how long the extension will last. We would like to have the certainty in the European Parliament what the composition of the Parliament will be in the first phase and in the second phase. For the European Parliament, games are not acceptable. Games on the expense of the European citizens and their representatives.
Su questa questione noi saremo fermissimi.
And we will be extremely firm on those questions, both towards the UK and towards the Council, because integrity, efficiency and dignity of the Parliament are not negotiable. That is what I told the heads of state and government, and I answered a few of their questions. I was asked if in
the case per i deputati britannici che sarebbero stati eletti per una durata di 5 anni, cosa dovrebbero fare?
What would happen non c'è nessuna to possibilità di British poter rimanere MPs nel Parlamento europeo perché non potrebbero decidere no come rappresentanti di un paese che non fa più parte dell'Unione Europea e dei cittadini che non sono più i loro concittadini europei. Ci sono domande on behalf of citizens who are still EU citizens. If there are any questions from you, I'd be happy to answer them too.
Thank you. It's Jennifer Rankin from The Guardian. We know that the European Council are seeking guarantees that the UK will not disrupt EU business if there is a long extension. So if there is a long extension of 9 to 12 months, for example, would the European Parliament be looking for guarantees in a similar way? For example, British MEPs would not be allowed to be rapporteurs or be chair or have senior posts in European Parliament committees. Could you give us an idea of what guarantees you would be looking for? And secondly, are you concerned that if there are elections in the UK, that there could be 73 Nigel Farages being returned to the European Parliament?
No, non mi preoccupa nulla la democrazia. La democrazia.
I'm not worried at all about democracy.
Se il Regno
democracy
Unito
is democracy.
Sarà parte dell'Unione Europea il giorno delle elezioni,
is part of the European Union on the day of the elections, the elections, the British citizens will select their own representatives. I don't have a problem with democracy at all.
La riduzione degli spazi democratici, ecco perché pretendiamo certezze su quello che si farà, garanzie
space.
Sui tempi.
We want guarantees, we want certainty.
Pienamente
for example, in terms
operativo.
Of the time frame, will MEPs be fully active? You know, they're supposed to be active full time during their mandate.
Il Regno Unito dovesse uscire,
but if the UK
anche i suoi rappresentanti
leaves, then
its
representatives
adesso.
In Parliament will leave as well.
Dato a tutti i deputati britannici la possibilità di svolgere nel modo migliore il loro lavoro, c'è stato soltanto un caso
British MEPs
che
to do their job in the best way possible. There was only one case of an MEP dealing with visa issues, Spain and the UK, and that person was asked not to continue in that post.
Presidente Moraes.
And President Bolaj followed that through.
Hello, it's James Crisp here from the Daily Telegraph. I'm over here, sir. Quick question. If Britain does hold European Parliament elections and then leaves the EU on June the 30th, as the Prime Minister is suggesting, I mean, doesn't that just make a mockery of the whole process of European elections? And slightly connected to that, Stanley Johnson, a former MEP and the father of Boris Johnson, has announced he will stand in the European elections. And I wonder if that gives you any inclination to comment. Thank you.
Ha detto che il Parlamento non intende essere preso in giro da chi che sia.
The Parliament will not be
si decide in maniera seria un periodo
by
di proroga per un tempo necessario
an extension period
per
is
risolvere
necessary,
i problemi con impegni chiari da parte
in order to resolve problems and if there
Consiglio,
are clear commitments on the British side and on Council's side.
Si deve fare tutto prima.
That's one possibility.
Noi, come or europeo, non
everything has to be done before the vote. We're not going to be taken for granted.
Electing MEPs
and then
them
not taking up their post. I mean, that, no, please, that's not possible.
Tutto ciò che lede l'immagine delle istituzioni, l'immagine
anything
della democrazia,
that harms the image of institutions
accadere.
And democracy
allora,
should be avoided, so we will stand very firmly on that point.
Cercherò di impedire qualsiasi azione che mortifichi l'istituzione che ho il privilegio e l'onore di guidare.
Fight any action that hinders the image of our institution and the people we represent. It's an election. Anybody can stand. If the Boris Johnson's father wants to stand, fine. And if he wants Wales. If he's elected, then he will be an MEP.
Io non ho mai problemi personali.
I don't have any personal issues. I may or may not agree.
I respect
everybody's positions, even when they're not my own. It's up to the citizens to decide whether my ideas or the ideas of others should be supported.
Anche quelli che sono contro l'Europa sono pienamente legittimi MEPs,
even those who are against Europe, if they're voted on, are legitimate representatives.
Presidente, Francesco Marascio, Reuters. Faccio domande in italiano, visto che...
Can I ask you a question in Italian?
No, mi chiedo, in caso la Gran Bretagna dovesse partecipare alle elezioni, i parlamentari britannici saranno in grado di poter votare per la nuova commissione? E se ci dovesse essere un cambio di equilibrio politico all'interno del Parlamento,
shift in the political balance within the Parliament,
appoggiata dalla nuova composizione del Parlamento, oppure ci dovrebbe essere un ritardo dell'estensione del termine dell'attuale
Would it be possible for the term of the current commission to be extended? Well, this is why I was saying we have to be extremely careful here. We mustn't play around with the institutions. We mustn't undermine democracy. So everything needs to be done very carefully. With great serenity, what we need is clarity from the UK and from the Council. So every agreement has to be clear and very precise. And it must avoid a sort of European puppet show
theatre. Perché
questo accada we'll deve essere un impegno chiaro, formale, end, but there has to be a clear framework, a clear commitment from the UK with a majority in British Parliament in favour of that. We can't accept flight forward and then a sudden retreat. I will fight to defend the dignity of the institution I represent because we are the only elected institution, so I have to defend it.
Thanks. Adam Fleming from the BBC. You talked about a transition formula. Could you just talk us through what the elements of that transition formula might be and what it could actually look like if, say, there was an extension till the end of December or until the end of March 2020?
No, bisogna sapere cosa chiede. We need to know what
Theresa May wants, what she's going to say on behalf of the British government and British Parliament. That's essential. We need to know what the British want to do. Do they want more time to decide in London? Do they want a referendum? Do they want an early election? Do they want to revoke Article 50? It's up to the British people and the British government to decide what they want. We have never said that they should leave. We're not applying pressure on them to leave. This is the free choice of a democratic country.
But
there are 27 other member states. There's the Parliament, there's the European Commission. We all want to know what the British have in mind. And then after that, we need to come up with clear answers as to how to proceed, what should be done in Parliament, what would any elected MEPs do, how long would their mandate last. We need to clarify things first. We need to know what the UK wants to do, when it wants to leave, if it wants to leave. So we're always open to discuss
this.
I mean, if there is to be an extension, it's not really a matter of how long that should be. What's the purpose? What's the point of the extension? I will fight anything that undermines the image of the Parliament.
Caroline Beisel for Süddeutsche Zeitung. A longer extension, like you said, would bring a lot of uncertainty maybe to the European Parliament. Do you feel the European Council shows the necessary respect for the Parliament as an institution, and does it do enough to protect its ability to function in the future? Thanks.
Uh,
Ripeto, è tutta una questione di serietà.
Well, I repeat, it's all a question of seriousness.
Non è una questione di tempo.
It's not a question of time.
Basta sapere cosa intendono fare i britannici e cosa intende fare il Consiglio.
And what the Council intends to do.
Quando si ha serietà e chiarezza, senza tentennamenti, senza ulteriori cambiamenti, noi possiamo regolare l'attività del Parlamento, che io devo difendere, ma mi pare che anche gli stati membri intendano difendere la dignità e l'integrità del Parlamento. Si può fare tutto, tranne che le cose poco serie. Queste sono inaccettabili, l'ho detto. Serious.
They are not acceptable. The Parliament is not a Punch and Judy
show. Thank you very much.
Show.
Have a nice evening.
Thank you very much.